Recovery efforts continue in Maryland's Patapsco River after one of Baltimore's most heavily traveled bridges, the Key Bridge, collapsed. It happened shortly after 1:30 a.m. Tuesday morning. Emergency responders began receiving calls that a large cargo ship that had just left Baltimore's port was out of control. Here is security camera video. The footage has been married to emergency dispatch audio the moment the ship slammed into a bridge support column, triggering the collapse. Watch.
I-695 East, be advised, 13 persons possibly in the water. There was a 13 person construction crew operating on the bridge, possibly in the water at this time.
Six to communications, are you advising there's 13 people in the water?
Possibly 13 people in the water, the construction crew.
As you heard, officials feared that there were 13, there was a construction crew that was working on the bridge at the time repairing potholes. And so the immediate safety concern was for all of them that might have been dumped into the water. All of these details, and again, this happened just before 2 a.m. All of these details were about including attempted water rescues were widely available to the media by the time most of the media went on the air at 6 a.m. And this includes conservative media. And yet, conservative media repeatedly claimed that this mass casualty event was the fault of President Biden. On Newsmax, guest Nancy Mace of South Carolina, Republican, attacked the Biden administration for not putting more money into bridge maintenance.
You look at the spending bill we did on Friday, all the waste that's in there, things that the government should not be paying for when it could be going to things that are the government's purpose, like this.
Just like this. Well, again, this particular bridge came down not because of bridge maintenance issues or construction problems. It came down because it was slammed by a giant cargo ship. And yet, there was Nancy Mace. Well, for people who actually are concerned about transportation maintenance, irrespective of what caused this particular accident, here's something to keep in mind. The infrastructure bill the Biden administration passed with very little help from Republicans in 2023 provided $40 billion for roads and bridges. Want to know who voted against this infrastructure bill? Oh yeah, Nancy Mace, Republican from South Carolina. Now, not to be outdone, on Fox News, Maria Bartiromo, a host on Fox, then this morning linked the bridge collapse to border security. Border security, even though Bartiromo in the same breath seconds earlier acknowledged there was no indication that this was anything but an accident.
There's no indication of the nefarious intent in the collapse of the Francis Scott Key Bridge. The ship involved in the collapse of the bridge is 948 feet long, called the Dolly, a Singaporean flagged container. But of course, you've been talking a lot about the potential for wrongdoing or potential for foul play given the wide open border. That is why you have been so adamant. Why has the Republicans had such a hard time securing this border? The president says he's not going to take his executive action.
This is what we call in the broadcast media a hard turn. And nobody does it more strangely and with less intelligence than Maria Bartiromo on Fox. Now, back to the bridge collapse. Authorities say that six workers now remain unaccounted for and presumed to have died. President Biden says the federal government will pay to rebuild the Key Bridge and reopen the Port of Baltimore, which is one of the biggest in the United States. And in the meantime, investigators are now looking at maintenance and inspection records for the cargo ship that lost power. The cargo ship apparently had just departed from the harbor, was en route out of there when it lost power. It flickered back on and off. And that's when the ship was apparently going about 15 miles per hour, slammed into the essentially a key holding part of the Key Bridge, causing it to collapse immediately. There's a lot to digest here, but first, the idea that conservatives on anywhere at the same time bodies are in the water, and you know that, and you're trying to somehow blame this on President Biden, what gives?
A lot of mainstream media don't give you honest news. We do. You know why? Because of you. Paid membership on YouTube makes all the difference. Hit the join button below, and you become the hero that sustains us.
It's just a lazy strategy. It's part of their playbook. Anything that goes wrong is obviously Joe Biden's fault. And obviously Joe Biden has never done anything right in the history of his presidency. That's the tack that they're going to take over and over. But I don't think we should expect anything better from the likes of Newsmax. Fox News, you might expect a little bit better. than Newsmax, but not really by much, right? At least Maria didn't go out and say Joe Biden was steering that ship. She just pivoted to a completely different subject matter altogether. But of course, you know, our thoughts go out to the families who are affected, the folks who died. In a lot of ways, man, this bridge collapsing feels like a metaphor for the American state. Just, you know, it's hard to come up with anything that the state is involved in, you know, buttressing or maintaining that is in, you know, a sharp incline. Everything seems to be in decline right now. And it's obviously a truly sad situation up there.
Right, it's passing the buck for everything that goes wrong and then taking credit for everything that goes right. And so with Nancy Mace, for example, from South Carolina, even though she voted against this particular massive infrastructure bill, she touted in her own district things that she says was she because of her somehow got put into the bill to help her district. So on the one hand, if she's blaming President Biden for not spending enough money to protect bridges, perhaps like this one in Baltimore, which got hit by the cargo ship. Well, then Nancy Mace, by her own logic, maybe she should take responsibility for the bridge collapse because clearly she took money away and diverted it to South Carolina that could have been used to somehow prevent this tragedy. That's how absurd all of this is. But what is it about Republicans who feel like they absolutely have to try to pull the wool over their own voters by taking credit for things that they opposed?
Because they know that ultimately the Republican Party's actual agenda is extremely unpopular. Deregulating the hell out of everything, giving the, you know, unlimited tax cuts to the very richest people in our nation. That's not popular with even Republican voters. So they can't come out and stump for the things that Republicans, the establishment anyway, actually want to do. So they go this other route and they try to do a sort of cloak and dagger approach to what their policies actually are. And it's beautiful. It's typified most, you know, ridiculously by Mitch McConnell, who fought the freaking infrastructure bill tooth and nail. This thing finally passes and he goes to his home state. He's in his home state of Kentucky and he starts bragging about the stuff that Kentucky's gonna get in said infrastructure bill. This is their approach. This is their strategy. It's ridiculous. And somehow they rarely ever pay the price for it.
Yeah. And by the way, I want to be clear to everybody. When you're, and I've been in the position of having to anchor breaking news where you're literally just sitting on a shot of whether it's a train derailment or a crash, and you don't know anything, and you've got hours and hours to fill. And sometimes it's very easy to go into sort of the speculation. You put on all the engineers and the experts you can. But maybe you want to take the opportunity of, okay, while we're waiting for more information, let's go ahead and have a debate or discussion about policy. And I can sort of understand, I suppose, the impetus to say, okay, while we're waiting for information, let's talk about infrastructure in general, even though it seems clear that this was caused by a cargo ship. What is the likelihood of bridges being more vulnerable because of lack of repair, because of not getting enough money? There's an artful and a sophisticated way to sort of pivot in that direction, but to sort of make the hard turn and leave your viewers with the impression that, oh, this is President Biden's fault because there should have been more money in the bill, or because Maria Bartiromo wants to talk about border security along the southwest border having something to do with a cargo ship slamming into a bridge in Baltimore, in the port of Baltimore. I mean, that doesn't even make any sense. And I guess I'm constantly surprised was that you think that even whether it's Newsmax or Fox News, I mean, these are broadcast organizations with sophisticated budgets. You'd think they would have broadcasters who would show a little bit more panache, a little bit more skill in saying, okay, we're going to move away from this particular topic as we keep this live picture up for hour number 5. And let's talk a little bit about some policy that may be a little bit unrelated. At least do something in terms of a transition that makes some sense, as opposed to being so herky jerky and amateurish about it.
Well, David, that's why we got outlets like TYT. That's why we're the good guys. You feel me? I don't know. They've been running this playbook of just outright cynicism, just the idea that their entire audience has been so right-wing pilled that they can't see or understand any of their deceptions or, you know, straight up out and out lies. I think they just go with that automatically on principle. And I'm not surprised by that. And, you know, not even just the Newsmaxes and the Fox Newses and whoever you want to get. I would say even in the mainstream, 20 years ago, David, this story would be leading the news for damn near 2 weeks. This is a calamity, a tragedy. We'd be figuring out how not to ever let this thing happen again. We'd be getting this thing right. Nowadays, I wonder if this will lead the news for more than a day and a half. And that goes for everybody. The big dogs who, you know, people claim that they're liberal to these sickos over on the right.
Well, the audience, certainly the attention spans have gotten shorter. And I wonder if all of this is sort of related to something you were talking about a minute ago. And that is, there is a lack of trust now in institutions, a lack of confidence in the people who bring you the news. And that was evident even this morning, where on X or Twitter, whatever we're calling Elon Musk's social media platform, there was so much stuff that was spewing out from people who claimed that this was a government conspiracy, that this was an effort to somehow take attention away from some issue that Joe Biden had. In other words, to immediately, when people are literally having their lives are being lost, they're drowning, cars are in the river, the port is closed. It's a horrible catastrophe, as you point out. And people, without knowing anything, are out there sort of feeding this conspiracy narrative that, oh, this must have been the CIA. This must have been the government that did this. The Biden administration is trying to hide something. And yeah, I mean, this sort of stuff, I suppose it existed 20 years ago. People would come up with these conspiracy theories, but they were laughed out of existence by the mainstream media. They'd say, no, we're going to cover this, and we're going to do a deep dive investigation into this cargo ship, and we're going to figure out exactly what happened, and we're going to, but it's so hard now to ignore the noise and the craziness that is out there from people who don't want to believe their own eyes or don't want to believe fire and EMS reports from the scene, but immediately want to somehow feed some kind of fan the flames of nuttiness by claiming this is all a big government conspiracy.
Here's what I'll say about the peanut gallery on Twitter, David. You don't make an anonymous profile with Elmo as your avatar in order to engage in measured, civil, nuanced discussion, debate, etc. You do that so you can let fly the craziest, most vitriolic nonsense that you can pull out of your butt. And so I'm not surprised by that in the least bit, David.
Interesting stuff. And again, as Waz was pointing out, condolences to everybody who was involved and all the families that were affected. Sir. And one can only hope that the divers are successful, at least bringing some recovery efforts there, and that people can get some answers as to why this cargo ship lost power and what happened. And of course, we'll probably find out sooner what went wrong with the cargo ship, then we'll find out what has gone wrong, and we'll be able to figure out what has gone wrong with so much in conservative media, which wants to try to score political points and freakishly blame everything that goes wrong on the Biden administration.
Thanks for watching the Young Turks. Really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.